And oh, Sylvia, you found out what I never meant you to know. But I don't mind that now, either." Sylvia took the old lady's thin white hand and kissed it. "I can never thank you enough for what you have done for me, dearest Miss Lloyd," she said earnestly. "And I am so glad that all mystery is done away with between us, and I can love you as much and as openly as I have longed to do. I am so glad and so thankful that you love me, dear fairy godmother." "Do you know why I love you so?" said the old lady wistfully. "Did I let that out in my raving, too?" "No, but I think I know. It is because I am Leslie Gray's daughter, isn't it? I know that Father loved you. His brother, Uncle Willis, told me all about it." "I spoiled my own life because of my wicked pride," said the old lady sadly. "But you will love me in spite of it all, won't you, Sylvia? And will you come to see me sometimes and write to me after you go away?" "I am coming to see you every day," said Sylvia. "I am going to stay in Spencervale for a whole year yet, just to be near you. And next year, when I go to Europe, thanks to you, fairy godmother, I'll write you every day. We are going to be the best of chums, and we're going to have a most beautiful year of comradeship." The old lady smiled contentedly. Out in the kitchen, the minister's wife, who had brought up a dish of jelly, was talking to Mrs. Spencer about the sewing circle. Through the open window where the red vines hung came the pungent, sun-warm October air. The sunshine fell over Sylvia's chestnut hair like a crown of glory and youth. "I do feel so perfectly happy," said the old lady with a long, rapturous breath. End of Chapter 2, Part 6. Chapter 3. Each in His Own Tongue, Part 1.